I'm Jerry Dennis. I'm a book author, and I've been doing this for 30 years. And when I started out, I had a really simple rule for myself. Write books about the things you care about. And one of the things I care about most and that I keep coming back to in book after book is the Great Lakes. Right now we're on Empire Bluffs, looking out towards Sleeping Bear Dunes, and down the hill from us is where I spent a summer when I was 5 years old. I think that summer in Lake Michigan shaped my whole life. My little brother, who was 3 when I was 5, and I would go to the beach with my mother, and we had it mostly to ourselves in those days. And she had grown up there, and she knew the natural history, and she knew the birds and the flowers and plants, and she taught us that. And I think the seeds of everything that I've done since then were planted that very summer. I literally fell in love with the Great Lakes. When I decided I wanted to be a writer when I was still in high school, I had the intuition that I should write about the things that I enjoy doing and I want to learn about. And you know, I had somebody tell me, write about what you know. Well, I also wanted to write about what I didn't know, what I was curious about. In the back of my mind, the whole time I was thinking, the Great Lakes, the Great Lakes. How can I write about the Great Lakes? How can I do justice to this vast subject? And one of the first things I remember writing about was Lake Michigan and the shoreline and the feeling of being there and the odd, interesting details like mirum grass, which is in some parts of the world it's called compass grass because it draws a circle in the sand as the wind shifts and the tip is dragging in the sand. I noticed that as a very young child and I wanted to write about it. I wanted to describe that because I found it so interesting and amazing. The first book I took on in 1986 was Canoeing Michigan Rivers. My old college friend and I, Craig Date, who was one of my best friends for life, set out and for 2 years we canoed the length of 45 rivers in Michigan. For quite a few years I circled the subject. How can I write about the Great Lakes? What can I do best to bring this subject to the attention of an audience? And I think I finally stumbled on it in 1999 when I realized the best way to tell the story of the Great Lakes is from boats. So the Living Great Lakes was the breakthrough for me. I realized this is how I can tell the story. And then for the next book, The Windward Shore, I said, well, instead of traveling through the lakes on boats, I want to stay in a few places because I saw so many places that I was fascinated with that I wanted to spend time with. So I stayed in cabins and cottages and a $20 million mansion on the shores of the Great Lakes to see what it was like there and to talk to the people and learn their stories and learn about their lives. One of the things I find so endlessly fascinating is that each of the lakes is different. I've described them in one of my books as like five sisters, each with a unique personality. Lake Superior is the wildest lake. You get out in the middle of Lake Superior, it's an ocean. You can't believe that you're on fresh water. Lake Huron is rugged. You're looking down 30 feet and you see rock, a lot of rock. Lake Michigan, it has a very different feel, a softer feel, because the shoreline is mostly sand. Lake Erie is the shallowest. It's windy. It tends to throw up some pretty rugged waves. You can get some bad storms on Lake Erie that hardly affect the other lakes. And Lake Ontario is unique as well. Once you drop below Niagara Falls, again, you've got a clear blue lake with a variety of shorelines. I guess it's natural. People are going to ask me, you know, what's my favorite place in all the Great Lakes? They often ask, what's my favorite Great Lake? And that's kind of tough because it really depends on where I am. But I have to say that where we're standing right now is one of my favorite places, not just in the Great Lakes, but on Earth. And I feel pretty lucky to be able to live near here and to have my family roots here as well.